Elise Oren drove from Houston this afternoon just for this.
Moving on, it's going to be the best, better product ever. And there's no reason for anybody to, you know, be worried, because when it does come out, it's going to be right.
Many in Brenham echo her support, but the creamery admits today that it will be off the shelves for months at minimum while they clean up.
We're taking a top-to-bottom look at everything we do because of this.
The FDA gave Channel 2 Investigates these documents that show 16 instances where Bluebell found listeria on the floor, water hoses, and drains. In Alabama, one of the findings states employees were not washing their hands. This Seattle-based food attorney says they never tested areas that could come in contact with food, but in the Broken Arrow plant, they did test ice cream for coliform.
The coliform counts were, in my view, incredibly high in finished product. And that means that although it doesn't specifically say that there was E. coli or listeria in it, the higher the coliform count, the more likely it is you're going to have a pathogen.
Because they knew about the high counts of coliform and still allowed products to be shipped, the consequences could mean legal trouble.
The other problem that Bluebell, I don't think, probably realizes that they have is they've got a potential for a criminal problem.
Speaking with Bluebell today, they wouldn't comment on whether or not they were hiring attorneys, but the simple thought of it is upsetting to their supporters.
I don't want a shake made with the custard stuff. I want my milkshake made with Bluebell.